Take glory, Father. Take glory, Son. Take glory, Holy Ghost, now and forevermore. Hallelujah. Take glory, Father. Take glory, Son. Take glory, Holy Ghost, now and forevermore. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Among the gods, who is like thee? Glorious in holiness, fearfully praises always do, in wonders, hallelujah. What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah. What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah. He made the blind to see. Hallelujah. He made the deaf to hear. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. We are on the mountain Zion. We are on the mountain Zion. We are on the mountain Zion. We are here to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. We are on the mountain Zion. We are on the mountain Zion. We are on the mountain Zion. We are here to worship the Lord. Holy Basin Kalaba. Father, we praise your name. We bless your holy name. We lift you high. We give you thanks. We give you glory, honor, and adoration for making us to see the second Sunday of the year 2022. It is by your power and your grace, O God. It is not by our making. It's not because we are so good or we are so perfect. It's by your kindness, your mercy, your compassion. It's by your love. Thank you, Father, for your unconditional love for us, for man, that you made us, you and I, watching me today, to see this brand new day, this beautiful day. Many went to bed yesterday night, they didn't wake up this morning. It is not by our making, oh God. Father, Lord, I thank you. We thank you. I thank you. I thank you for myself. I thank you on behalf of everybody. Thank you, oh God, for those that are still on the journey of life and those that woke up this morning and still have the opportunities to fulfill their destinies. Oh, Father, Lord, you are wonderful. This is just a beautiful opportunity, oh God. Lord, I pray that none of us will misuse it in the name of Jesus. Because time waits for no man, oh God. Give us the encouragement, the power, the knowledge, the know-how, the intelligence, the wisdom to make use of our time right in time, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I cast out procrastination from everybody's lives. I pray, oh Lord, that you shall be, oh Lord, the author and the finisher of our faith, on whose back on we ride upon, so that we can reach our destinies, so that we can reach the peak of what you have prepared for us in life, in Jesus' name. Many died without even living a similitude of the life you have planned for them. Many died poor. Many died sick, whereas you planned good health, abundance in riches for them, but they never attained it. I decree and I declare that you and I's portion shall never be like that in the name of Jesus. Lord, as we seek you, we will find you. Take preeminence of this platform this afternoon and reach lives, oh Lord, in Jesus' name. I surrender all to you, Jesus. I decree so that you may increase in me. Holy Spirit of the living God, I depend on you. I reverence you. I need you. In the name of Jesus. Father, take charge of my lips of this vessel, oh God, and speak forth the words of life in the name of Jesus. Let every hearer of the word, including me, oh God, let it penetrate our hearts and germinate and sow seeds that will manifest and change our lives for good. In the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you have your way, oh Lord, today in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Now I cover all of us in the blood of Jesus. I sanctify this arena. I sanctify this page. I sanctify this page by the blood of Jesus. I spring the blood of Jesus over everywhere. I barricade every weapons or every agent of darkness. I barricade them all. I decree that they shall not penetrate onto this platform in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, have your way. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen, 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 in Jesus' name, amen. Praise amen. The Lord, praise the Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the living Jesus, hallelujah. Glory, 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 honor, and adoration be given unto our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. Again, I welcome you all to this platform. Jesus Christ is my message, prophetic ministries, and as you all know, my name is Evangelist Esther Olayinka Diya. I thank you all for joining me today for this program. I promise I will not be long at all. I will not take your time. I will not be long at all on this program. I welcome you. We are still ushered. It's still a brand new year that we have ushered into. The Lord will sojourn through this year with us in the name of Jesus. We shall not pass on this journey by ourselves in Jesus' name. The Lord will be our refuge, our fortress. He will be our strength. He will hold our hands so that we will not fall into the pit as we journey through this 2022 in the name of Jesus. He will carry us up in his arms so that we will not fall in Jesus' name. As you can see, the title of the topic today, I titled it The Complete Package of a Christian. The Complete Package of a Christian. And this is just in line also. It's still in line with welcoming you into the brand new year. And today, I just want to prophesy goodness upon everyone here, including myself. I just want to prophesy to us. Blessings unto us for the new year. That is what the purpose of this day is today. And I want to bring you to the book of Deuteronomy 28 for this prophecy, for this blessing that is going to occur today. I'm bringing us to the book of Deuteronomy 28. I'm going to read the book of Deuteronomy 28 from verses 1 to verse 15. Please, I want you to patiently go along with me as I go. It says in Deuteronomy 28, it says, "And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth." This is Moses speaking to the Israelites after he had brought them out of bondage of Egypt, and he gathered them together and he began to tell them the blessings of God and what riches of his goodness and his kingdom. What how beautiful it is if they will hearken unto the voice of the Lord, which is the word of God, which is the Bible. Which is the Bible? I want to encourage everyone to please, if you don't have a Bible this year, 2022, this is what you need most. You need this more than you need your phone. Trust me, you need this more than you need your phone. So Moses is pronouncing blessing upon them, telling them the benefit that is in serving the Lord. So it says that if you hearken unto the voice of the Lord, verse 2 says, and all these blessings shall come upon thee and overtake thee if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of God. All the blessings in this Deuteronomy 28 verses 1 to 15 shall come upon thee if you hearken unto the voice of the Lord. He says, blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the field. That means wherever you are, you will be blessed. Whether in the city, whether at home, whether at work, whether in the bus, whether in the train, whether in the car, whether you are in the midst even of your enemies, you will be blessed. That is the word of the Lord. And once God said, it is done, it will not come back to him void. Hallelujah. His father says, blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruits of thy ground, and the fruits of thy cattle, and the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. He's telling you that blessed shall you be, and blessed shall be your increase, your flocks, your children, which is your the fruits of your body, your children. You will be blessed. Whatever you lay your hands upon will be blessed. Whatever you do will be blessed. Whatever you aspire to and you begin to do, it will be blessed. Your children will be blessed because you hearken unto the voice of the Lord. I says in verse 5, blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. That means blessed will be all that you gather together. When you work, we all know, even in the olden days, they go to farm, they farm their flocks and their sheep, and it's God increases it and blesses it. Today we go to work, we save, we aspire to buy houses, buy cars, train our children to school, get married, and all these things will be blessed. Everything you gather in the bank, your money in the bank, your flocks, your stocks, your businesses, ventures, they will all be blessed. That is what to say, because you are keen unto the voice of the Lord. Blessed shall thou be when you come in and be when you go out. And the Lord shall cause thy enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come against you one way and flee before thee seven ways. That is verse 7. He's saying to you that the Lord shall cause your enemies to be smitten before thee. The Lord will make you see your enemies be put to shame. The Lord will dethrone your enemies and enthrone you there. The Lord will remove your enemies from your path. The Lord will protect you. He has his armor around you. You dwell in his secret place. That is what this is saying to you. That even if they gather against you in one way, they will flee seven ways. When your enemies come against you, when they come together and they come against you, they flee seven ways. That means God, the Lord will so much come into battle against them on your behalf, so much more that they will not even know where they are. They will just begin to run helter skelter and run away. They will not even follow one pattern. That is how confused, how afraid, how destroyed they will be because of you, because you are hearkening unto the voice of the Lord. He said they will flee, your enemies will be put to shame. God will put the robe of shame upon them because you hear and hearken unto the voice of the Lord this year 2022. I'm saying all this to prepare you for year 2022. How you should stay close, niche with God. When you do that, these blessings will follow you. When you, in this year 2022, if you stand with God, God will stand with you. If you walk with God, God will walk with you. The Bible in Matthew 7:40 says, if you knock, the door shall be opened unto you. When you seek, you will find. When you ask, you will be given. That is the word of God. He said, while you are yet speaking, he has heard you. When you speak once, God has heard you twice. Those are his promises for this year 2022 concerning your life. Amen. Hallelujah. And it's also going further to say that the Lord shall command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouses, and all that thou sittest your hands upon, it shall bless thee in the land with the Lord that God giveth thee. Wherever you are, the Lord will establish you. That's what he's saying, that you will not beg for bread. I have now, since I am young, now I'm old, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. That is the word of the Lord. You can never be forsaken. God will bless you. If you have been going astray before and be making mistakes before, once you walk with God and stand with God, the Lord will make every crooked path to be straight. He will help you. If you have been, you don't know how your monies have been going, you have a basket, a bank account, you don't know how the money is dripping away, or you'll be spending lavishly, or you don't even, the Lord will put, we help you gather your stock together, gather your blessings together. They will not drain anymore when you stand with God, when you walk with God. Hallelujah. So this is a clarion call to all believers and even unbelievers to come to Christ. Stand with Jesus. Stand with God this year 2022. Hallelujah. He said that your storehouses shall be full. Your bags will be full. Your pockets shall be full. Your table shall never be devoid of food. You will be blessed in the day, in the afternoon, in the night. The people shall call you blessed in the name of Jesus. You will be celebrated in the name of Jesus. That is the word of God for your life. The Lord shall establish thee and holy people unto himself, as he has sworn unto thee, if thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways. The Lord will establish you and holy people. You know how he will establish you? Because your enemies will try you. Your enemies will throw stones at you. They will throw arrows at you. But because you are with God, God will make that arrow go back to their sender. When the arrow hit your enemies back, then the enemies will be able to testify that the God of you, the God of I, Esther Olayinka Diya, is God indeed. The God of who, whoever you are watching me, is God indeed. That is what God will say, will do for you. That is what he's saying to you, that he will establish you as holy people. Your enemies will know that God has established you and holy people. Your enemies will know that you are untouchable, that your ground is a solid ground, is a dangerous ground for the enemy to tread upon. The Lord will make you untouchable, will turn you to fire. Hallelujah. That is what God will do for you this year 2022. Get ready. You walk with God and you will see the blessings flow after. You will walk in abundance. Hallelujah. And verse 10 says, and all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee. The enemies will be afraid of thee. Hallelujah. The people of the earth shall know that you are called by this God. They shall be afraid of thee. Remember, when Elijah called upon fire from heaven, and it consumed all, and it accepted the sacrifices that he brought, they knew that there is God indeed. And also there was he commanded the fire to destroy all the prophets of Baal and Baal itself. They were afraid of Elijah. Hallelujah. Likewise, it shall be unto you. The Lord will make your enemies to be afraid of you. The people of the world shall be, they will be in awe of you. They will know that you serve a living God. Hallelujah. Verse 11 says that, and the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, and in the fruits of thy body, and in the fruits of thy cattle, and in the fruits of thy ground, in the land which the Lord swore unto thy fathers to give thee. Yes, you shall have inheritance in the Lord. You shall be blessed in the Lord. That's what God is telling you there. You shall be in abundance. You will not lack anything. The ground will yield its fullness unto you. You will steal a little. You will reap abundantly in the name of Jesus. And the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven, to give thee rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. You shall never borrow. Rather, you shall lend to many nations. The Lord will water your fruit, your seed, anything that is in your hand. The Lord blesses us by what is in our hands. So he's asking you today, I'm asking you, what is in your hands? Open your hands and let the Lord bless them. When you sow that seed, that little thing, that thing you think is insignificant, when you sow it, the Lord will bless it. Whatever is in your hand, the Lord will bless it. Whatever business enterprise you open up, no matter how little, no matter how you may not have faith in it, the Lord is saying to you today that He will bless it this year 2022. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will bless it. He said, the Lord said, He will give you rain in due season. The heavens shall be continually open unto you. Heavens will open for your sake. When you are here speaking, when you are speaking, the Lord will hear you. Your heavens will continually be open. Rain will fall upon your seed. Blessings of God will rain upon you. When the favor of God will be your companion, it will go before you anywhere you go. The people will like you. They will choose you above everybody. You'll be the best amongst your equals. You'll be the first and not the last. Those are the promises of God concerning your life. The Lord is saying to you that you will lend to many nations. You will not borrow. Nations will come to you to ask, and you shall give them in Jesus' name. Verse 13 says, and the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. I said that. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. And thou, if thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. That is what this God is saying. If you hearken unto the voice of the Lord your God, the Lord will bless you with all these blessings. He will make the head and not the tail. The Lord will make you a voice wherever you are, anywhere you are. People will reckon with you. You will be a force to reckon with. You shall not be a throw aside. You shall not be a washover. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. He said that you shall always be ahead and not beneath. You shall be a blessing even to your generation. The Bible says that Abraham's blessings are yours. You'll be a carrier of blessing. Anywhere you go, they will be blessed. Anything you touch will be blessed. Anybody you come across or in connection with will be blessed. Because the blessings of the Lord is with thee in the name of Jesus. So fear not. I'm telling you, this year 2022 shall be great. This year 2022 shall be a blessed year for you if only you hearken to the voice of the Lord. The secret to the blessings in this year 2022 is to hearken unto the voice of the Lord. What is the voice of the Lord? The Word of God, the Bible. And those of you that do not know what I'm talking about, probably you are not born again, but probably you are not a Christian. I want to encourage you now to give your life to Jesus. To give your life to Jesus. You need Christ to walk this walk. You need Jesus to walk this walk. You need Jesus to go with you, to hold your hands. You cannot do it alone this year 2022. You need Jesus with you. You need Jesus with you. We can see all the pestilences, sicknesses here and there, ravaging people. Almost, I mean, we do the twinkle of an eye. The COVID has swamped in the new variant, which is the Omicron, is just as engulfed almost the whole nation. But we thank God that it is not the killing one like that of COVID-19. Like that of 2020, when people were dying en masse. Thank God that this time around, people are getting healed. As they get this COVID, they're getting healed. I give glory to God for that. We are not burying and weeping and wailing and losing our homes like it happened in the year 2020/21. Thank God that at least God is professing, giving us a healing, and people are getting healed. As they are going to the hospital, they are drinking their antibiotics or whatever they are giving to suppress it. They are getting healed. We give glory to God that they are coming out of it, not dying in it. God's mercy is still there. It's still sufficient for us. That shows us His mercy, that He heard our prayers. He heard our call, where that we cried upon Him, unto Him, from year 2020 through 21, even up to date. He heard us. That is why we are getting well. Imagine how many people would have died by now if people were dying. Because in America here, we did a trickle over here, thousands are, you know, coming out that they have COVID. Thousands and thousands and thousands every day. Multiple in thousands. Almost every household, somebody, almost in every household, somebody has COVID. Hallelujah. So God is still God. He still loves us. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And as you believe, you have to hearken unto his word. Like I was saying before, you that have not given your life to Jesus, please repeat after me. Today is your day. Tomorrow may be too late. Please repeat after me. I mention your name. I come before thee today. I confess of all my sins. I renounce them. I will not do them no more. I ask for you to have to forgive me. I give my life to you, Jesus, from today on. Please take control. I surrender all to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. I welcome you into the household of God. If you have repeated that after me, congratulations to you. You are welcome to the household of God. Now, I want to encourage you to look for a Bible-believing church around you and begin to worship with them. Bible says where two or more are gathered in their midst, he is. And the Bible says that faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. As you commune with the children of God, your faith increases in the word that you hear, because you will hear the word of God. You will hear you will feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. And God will come and commune with you. Jesus Christ, we hold your hands in the name of Jesus. You are welcome. I also want to encourage you to pick up a Bible and begin to read and familiarize yourself with the word of God. You can start reading from the book of the gospel according to Mark or John. Those are simplified gospels that will introduce you to Jesus, and you will know more about Christ. And as you know more about Christ, the Lord will increase you in wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. The Lord will open your eyes to see mysteries. You will see in visions and in dreams. God will visit you. He will reveal himself to you more and more daily in the name of Jesus. And God will continue to transform you, to conform more like Christ every day. And you shall never fall. You shall never fail. You shall never go back. You will make it to heaven in Jesus' name. That is my prayer for you. I want to encourage us all again to please hearken unto the word of God, so that all these blessings shall be yours. All these blessings shall be yours. Verse 14 here says, and thou shalt not go aside. Let me read from 13 to 14 so that you get a total package of what I'm leaving you with. He says, and the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. This is a commandment of the Lord. God is saying to us, do this, and I will bless you. These are my words. If you follow through with all I've been saying, I'm reading Deuteronomy chapter 28 from verses 1 to 14. Hearken unto those words. Hearken, follow through, obey his commandments. And verse 14 says, and thou shalt not go aside from any of the words. If you don't go aside, if you don't leave one and take one. So for instance, some people will say, I'm a born again Christian, but God did not say we should not marry more than one, or we can marry 2 to 3 wives. No, God didn't say that. He didn't say go ahead and marry 2 to 3 wives. So that is give your life to Jesus, but going aside from it, choosing one and leaving the other, is the total package. You have to accept the total package. Some people will say, God, I give my life to Jesus, but God did not say we should not drink beer, we should not smoke or do drugs. No. They say, show me in the Bible where God saying don't do drugs. You see, don't be manipulative of the word of God. Just let the Spirit of God flow through you. Accept Christ and the Holy Spirit will minister unto you. He will tell you the do's and the don'ts. And if you're sincere, you will know what the Holy Spirit is telling you is exactly what is in the Bible about what to do and what not to do. The Holy Spirit will teach you all things. He will hold your hands and lead you. He will counsel you. He will be your companion, your teacher, your helper, your fortress. He will be there for you. the Holy Spirit, when you give your life and when you decide to hearken unto the word of the Lord, the Holy Spirit is there to interpret everything, every situation that confronts you, that you are, you know, confused about. Put it tabled before God, before the Holy Spirit. He will teach you what to do. He will give you knowledge, deep insight, understanding of that situation. In the name of Jesus, He said, "If you do not go aside, do not go. If you do not go aside from any of the words which I've commanded thee this day, to the right or to the left, to go after other gods to serve them, don't go aside of it. When you go aside of it, you're already embracing other gods in your heart. That means even when you reject some part of the word of God, for instance, those that want to drink now and still want to smoke and say I'm born again, you have made that smoke and that drink like a god in your heart. It does not necessarily have to be a molten god or a carved out image or brass that you place on the floor and bow before. Not necessarily that. Whatever you hold in importance that you know is not right, but you cannot let go of for the kingdom, for God, for the word of God, that has constituted a god in your heart. So he's saying, if you do not stay away from the word of God, God is saying to you in verse 14 here, Deuteronomy 28, verse 14, if you do not stray away from all these things that I've commanded you not to do, but you follow through with it, you do not go aside from it to the left or to the right, to go after other gods to serve them. If you do not do away with them and pursue other gods, you know, this includes those that are worshipping images and those that are not worshipping images but have constituted, made something else more important in their life, made money more important in their life. So people are in pursuit of these riches so much more that they neglect the word of God. They put it to the side. They are part-time Christian. They are part-time born again. And they are not doing that. God said, if you are neither hot or cold, He will spill you out of His mouth. He will spill you out. You have to be hot for Christ. You have to, God has to know where you stand. Hallelujah. So I'm encouraging you this year, 2022, that do not make other gods your God. Don't run after other gods. God is a jealous God. He does not share His glory with anyone. Obey the word of God. This package is a total package for the believer. Deuteronomy 28, 1 to 14 is a total package to live by. It's a good manuscript to follow through. If you follow through this, you cannot miss it. You cannot miss heaven. In the name of Jesus, follow through with this year 2022 and it shall be well with you. Do not pursue other gods in Jesus' name. When I come back again, I will do the part 2 of this message about what God means here about going after other gods. I will expatiate more about it. Amen. So today, I thank you for watching. I thank you for staying with me. And those that are still going to watch, may God bless you all. May God increase you, enlarge you. May God crown all your efforts this year in the name of Jesus. I speak over your life that the Lord will open new gates of favor to you as you go forth this year, this week, in the name of Jesus. As you go this week, you will come back with testimonies in Jesus' name. The Lord will enlarge you. He will increase you. He will open the heavens will be open over you and bless all your endeavors. You will not labor in vain in Jesus' name. This year, the Lord will make you laugh. Everything that has caused you to cry and weep and be in sorrow, this year, the Lord will give you joy over them, and testimonies will fill your lips concerning them all in Jesus' name. If you have children that has made you sorrowful, if you have children that has made you sad prior to now, this is the time. The Lord will make them a joy unto you in Jesus' name. He will bless you. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 I release you to the capable hands of God, of the Holy Spirit, to go with you this week. I'll come back next week with testimonies in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks for watching. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you.